Hey guys, quick question here. Have you said a yes to someone when you actually want to say a no and then somewhat regret later? Then make sure you stick around till the end of this video, because in this video, I will be telling you some super swift ways how you could say no to someone politely without feeling guilty or not regretting later. So without wasting much time, let's get started. I never made it, but I know what it takes. Someone is hated by a mix of... Hey guys, I'm Anisha and welcome back to my channel. So if you're that kind of a person who ends up saying yes to most of the people most of the times while keeping your priorities aside just because you don't want to hurt them, then the number one tip that I would want to give you is stop feeling guilty for saying no. Consider saying no to someone as a part of your self-care or self-benefit. You need to understand that saying no to someone doesn't necessarily make you a bad person or make you look selfish. If you genuinely don't want to do something, there is no harm in saying a no and considering it as an act of self-care. Saying something that you don't believe in or that is not on your priority list is something that you do to yourself and your well-being, and doing something for your well-being is not considered rude or selfish. So that is why, my friends, just because you said no to a person, you need to stop thinking that people are going to think bad about you or consider you as a bad human being. The number two tip that I have for you guys is to start saying no more often. After you have established that saying no to someone doesn't make you a bad person, you need to start using the word more often. You need to get a hang of saying no to people. I can assure you, in the beginning, it's going to be a bit weird and there's always going to be that awkward, creepy feeling that is in your head and your inner voice saying, say yes, when you actually have to say no. So you need to start getting comfortable saying no to people. Start saying no to things that you don't like, impractical favors, things you don't want to indulge in, work you're not going to be paid for, or anything that makes you uncomfortable. By saying no more often, there are two things that will happen here. First, you will get used to saying no, and the second, people will start getting used to hearing a no from you. Go ahead and start using the no word more often so that people and you get comfortable with it. Now, the third and one of the most important tip is to stop apologizing for saying no. So when we are saying no to someone, we usually feel that we are going to hurt that person and start our statements with stuff like, sorry yaar, but I can't make it today, or something like, I'm really sorry, I cannot help you today. Then probably the opposite person might just make a sour face or get into a grumpy mood, and then you start feeling guilty thinking that you have spoiled that person's mood. I know you are genuinely a very sweet person at heart, and that is why you have started your denial with a sorry. But apologizing while saying a no just makes your no seem a bit weaker. I'm not telling you to be rude here, but saying a sorry with an apology makes you get on a weaker side. So my suggestion would be, just be firm while saying sorry next time. Now you said a no and you're not going to say sorry. Now the next point that I want you to keep in mind is, don't give a long explanation as to why you said a no. It is very important that you keep it brief here. If you give a very long explanation as to why you said a no, it will only give the opposite person to find loopholes in your reasons. It is important to make sure that your reasons are not too long and not too specific, even though your intentions are just to be polite. Remember that you don't owe an explanation to people to do something for yourself. The next one, what you could do is you could have a not to do list. Just like you have a to do list, you can have a not to do list. I know this might sound a bit weird, but you can make a list of things that you certainly don't want to do or have done these things in the past and had a bad experience and don't want to do it again, no matter how much someone forces you. To maintain work-life balance, you can have things on your list like, you won't receive calls after 10 p.m. or you won't answer any email before reading the newspaper in the morning, or anything that you feel comfortable with. Anything that you don't want to do should certainly be on that list, so that next time someone asks you to do that, you can straight away say a no without rethinking about it. Now the next tip is to offer a solution when you have to say a no. Most of the times you genuinely want to be helpful to that person, but you just cannot due to some commitment issues. Next time that you want to be helpful to someone, let them know that you appreciate being considered and offer them an equally helpful solution. Last one is for you guys who generally get trapped in the sales talk given by aggressive salesmen. When you know you're being forced to say a yes when you want to say a no, what you could do is you could buy yourself some time. Instead of saying a straight off no, let them know that you'll get back to them later. Note that they require a balance of yes and no's in your life. If you know that someone is genuinely upset and wants to spend time with you on the weekend, don't act like a couch potato and just watch Netflix. Instead, just go out and be there for them, because that's what friends are for, right? That's it, folks, for today. Hope this video eases out some mental stress of yours and keeps you guilt-free. So this was my 11th video online, and I know I've not been consistent, but I'm really happy with all the support that you guys have given me. Thanks to my YouTube channel, I've gotten to know quite a few of you who want to start their YouTube channel and keep asking me questions like where I record, how I record, which camera I use, what lighting I use, or something on those lines. Let me tell you that I'm not a very rich person, and I genuinely do all of these things, right from editing, scripting, recording, like all of it just on my phone. And I would love to share this with you all, and that is why in my next video, I will be telling you how I run my YouTube channel just with my phone. I know I'm not a very pro at it, and I just have somewhat around 200 subscribers, but I will tell you what I've genuinely learned from these 10 videos. So the ones interested in that, stay tuned for it, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Smash the bell icon next to it so that you get notified first when the next video is out. And since you're here, you can definitely check out the other videos on my channel. Start by the one that is flashing on your screen right now. Bye for now, guys. See you later.